Hey everyone, I'm Bhagat Gaur. Today we are going to talk about how to download and install Stable Diffusion on your PC and run it without an internet connection or any limitations. A quick disclaimer, I'm a 3D artist and I do not support AI generated images at all. Then why am I making this video? The good thing about Stable Diffusion is that it will not generate any art style unless we give an artist's name in the prompt, which means we are not stealing any type of art by default. If you are a 3D artist, with help of the Stable Diffusion image-to-image tool, you can provide your own renders, and with a few lines of prompt, you can generate multiple versions of your render in different styles, which helps you add more details to your render. This Stable Diffusion lets you generate custom PBR textures, upscale the quality of your current images, and also use the generated images as a reference. You can learn everything that I said in the next part of this tutorial. In the current tutorial, I walk you through installing Stable Diffusion and generating stunning images. Let me clear up basic questions that probably raise in your mind. What is Stable Diffusion? Stable Diffusion is a text-to-image generator that can give you photorealistic outputs, and it's open-source software just like Blender. Question 2. What GPUs are compatible to run Stable Diffusion? On NVIDIA and AMD GPUs with 6GB or more, you can run Stable Diffusion. In my case, I'm using an NVIDIA RTX 3070 8GB graphics card. If you don't have a recommended graphic card, you can still use Stable Diffusion from their official website for free. You may ask, why should I install it on my PC when there is a free version available? I will explain that further in this video, so please watch it to the end. Question 3. How much storage and internet do I need to run Stable Diffusion? You need to download Python, which is around 27 MB. Git installer, which is 51 MB, Stable Diffusion web UI, which is around 10 MB, Stable Diffusion model, which is around 4.2 GB, and additional files installing Stable Diffusion will be around 2.5 GB. In total, it costs you around 8 GB to install this, and make sure you have at least 15 GB of storage on your hard drive. You don't need to do any complicated things while installing. Don't worry about all of these things. You just need to download and use it. Let me explain clearly why you need them all. When you type a prompt in Stable Diffusion, every information like animals, people, objects, art styles, etc. to generate images are stored in this 4.27 GB file. The design and everything we are seeing here is Stable Diffusion web UI. And to install this from the command prompt, we need to install Git. And everything here works with the help of Python scripts, so we need to install Python, which is around 27 MB. If that's been clear, let's start the installation process. To download Python, search download Python on your browser and open the first link. For everything I'm downloading, the links are in the description. First, I install the latest version, but some scripts are not compatible with Python's latest version, and the 3.10.6 version worked good for me. Click on it and scroll down to the bottom. And click on Windows Installer and save it. For Git, search download Git, click on the first link, and then click on Windows. To download the model, search Hugging Face Stable Diffusion version 1.5. Click on the first link, and if you want to learn more about this model, you can go through this. To download model, click on Files and Versions, and scroll down. Here you can find Stable Diffusion version 1.5, and it comes in two variations, one around 4GB and the other around 7GB. A lot of people said that both give similar results, so I downloaded the 4.27.ckpt file. The save tensors is the save variant of the ckpt file, but I did not know this before, so I downloaded the ckpt file. You can download any of these, there is no need to worry about that because these are the official Stable Diffusion files and I don't think there will be any malicious files in it. Since I already have this file, I'm not going to download it again. Now let's start the process by installing both Python and Git. Double click on Python, enable add it to path and install it. Now let's install the Git. Double click on it and click on next a bunch of times. and that's it. Now we can install Stable Diffusion Web UI from GitHub. Create a folder where you want to download the Stable Diffusion. I created a folder with the name AI on the D drive. Go to browser and search Stable Diffusion Web UI Automatic 1111 and hit enter. Click on the first GitHub link. Move your mouse to the code and click on it. Copy the link. Now go to where you want to install Stable Diffusion. I'm installing in D drive in a folder called AI. Click in the address bar and type cmd and hit enter. Now type git space clone space and paste the copied link and hit enter. It will download the Stable Diffusion Web UI in the AI folder. Close the command prompt and open the Stable Diffusion Web UI folder. Go to Models, Stable Diffusion, and paste the 4.2 GB model we downloaded from the Hugging Face. Now the final part. Go back to Stable Diffusion Web UI folder and scroll down. Here you will find the Web UI user.bat. This is the file you should open if you want to run Stable Diffusion. Before that, I want to add a little code to it to download the latest version every time I open it. If you don't want to, you can skip this step because you can also update it after opening Stable Diffusion. Right click on the bat file, show more options, click on edit. In the first line, add git space pull and save it. Then close the file. Now when I double click on it, it will download the required files and it will download around 2.5 GB. So run it by double clicking and waiting for it to complete. If you install the latest version of Python, you will get an error while downloading a file called .h. That's why I recommended you to download the old version. I have done this process before, so it will take the files from the cached folder. Wait for some time and it will complete the process depending on your internet speed. If your file has stuck at some point without error, wait for some time. And if it still has not done anything, hit spacebar in the command prompt and wait for some time. It will be completed. If you get any error, copy that error and search for it on the internet and you will find the solution. After completing the process, you will get a link to open Stable Diffusion. You can either copy and paste it in your browser or control left click it to open it in your default browser. Finally, here is the Stable Diffusion. Before learning how to use Stable Diffusion, please hit a like on this video for helping you to download Stable Diffusion. Go through my channel. If you find any videos useful, then please subscribe to this channel. It helps me a lot. Now let's learn how to use Stable Diffusion. At the beginning of the video, I said you could also use it from their official website for free without any limit. Let's open that on the side and compare both. Now let me type the same prompt in both web and local versions. Click on Generate Image. Now you know why installing locally is the best. For the web version, you have to wait in the queue. And after the queue, it takes a long time to complete the process. Not only that, you have a lot of restrictions while using the web version, even though we intend not to generate unsafe content. For example, you want to generate an image of a cute kid holding a knife cutting bread. Let's see what it generates. Processing. And we get an error. What did this error message say? Unsafe content found, please try again with different prompts. But why? Because the words knife and kid are in the same prompt, which is considered unsafe content. And if you try the same prompt differently, you can get the result, but you know how much time you have to spend to achieve that. And you are unable to add your custom styles to the prompt, which we will learn in the process. And remember not to close the command prompt while using Stable Diffusion. If you do that, it will stop working. Let's open Stable Diffusion again by clicking on the bat file. If you don't want to open the folder every time, you can create a shortcut to the bat file and paste it on the desktop for quick access. On the top left, you will find a Stable Diffusion checkpoint. You can change different types of models from here. I have this Midjourney version 4 model, which will achieve similar images to Midjourney. And I have Dreamlike Photoreal, which generates photorealistic humans based on this Stable Diffusion version 1.5 model. You can download this if you want from Hugging Face website, where we downloaded the Stable Diffusion model. Links are in the description. Here is the text-to-image tool. You already know what to do with this. In the prompt, you will give inputs with commas, like before. And in the negative prompt, we will give what we don't want in our image generation. For example, blurred, pixelated image, bad quality, ugly face, bad proportions, and extra fingers. Everything should be separated by a comma. The sampling method is a different type of image generation. Everything here does the same image generation, but the way it takes our input and generates it differently will result in a unique style. You can experiment with this while trying different type of styles, or you can leave it as the default and still get the best results. The sampling steps. The sampling steps are to tell how many times the image should improve. Lower values gives fewer details, and higher values gives a lot of details. But it takes a lot of time to produce results. Leaving it the default setting gives you the best results. If you feel the image has less detail, you can increase the steps. Restore faces. Restore faces will help with generating human faces. It will try to fix the faces after completing the generation. You should turn on this before generating any human face. Tiling. If you are a 3D artist, you already know what tiling is. The tiling creates an image in such a way that if we place the same image on the sides of the current image, it will still look like there is no cut in between. High-res fix, which stands for high-resolution fix, which will generate an image and then upscale it. I never tried this before because you can also do this from this extra step. This is the image dimension. The default values are set to 512 by 512, which will create 1:1 ratio images. You can change the value according to your creations, but remember not to add high resolution if you have less GPU power. It will take a long time. Let's add 1024 by 512. Batch count. Batch count will ask how many images you want to generate with the given prompt. If you want to generate multiple variations with one prompt, you can give a number and it will generate that many images using a single prompt. Let's enter 4 for now. The batch size. The batch size will be the count of how many images it should generate at a time. Suppose we added 4 images. If we add a batch size of 2, it will generate 2 images at a time until it creates 4 images. I recommend not changing it unless you have a high-powered GPU. I'm leaving it as it is. The CFG scale. The CFG scale will ask how strongly it should follow the given prompt. If the default value did not provide what you asked for, then you can increase this a bit and try it. Leaving it at default will also generate a good creative image. You can also give importance to a particular word in the prompt by using brackets. It takes the words that are in the bracket as important words. Seed. Seed will be more useful if you want to create the same style again and again. For instance, if you are generating random images and you find an image beautiful and you want to create something in the same style, then you can use the seed of the image by pasting it here and it will create something similar to what the seed generated before. And leaving it at -1 will generate a random seed. In a moment, I will tell you where this seed can be found. Let's click on generate and see what we will get. You can also see the process in the command prompt. If you are generating something and it is not doing anything, then you should open the command prompt and check what's going on. Sometimes if you click on a new button and the recommended files are not present in your system, it will start downloading it. So always check the command prompt for details. Here you can see what prompts was added to create this image. Every image automatically stores the prompt, negative prompt, sample step, seed, and the model you created. Everything will be stored inside the PNG file. If someday while going through your generated image, you want to check the details, you can easily do that with the PNG info tool. Let me show it to you. Every image that you create will be stored in the same folder where we installed the Stable Diffusion. Open the folder, search for outputs. In the outputs, you will find all of your generated images. In our case, we generated our images through text-to-image. So open that file and here you can find them. Select one of the images and drag it into the Stable Diffusion and drop it in the PNG info. Here you can see all of the details. You don't have to copy paste it into the text to image. Instead, use this send to text to image button and it will send these details to text to image section. Experiment with what you have learned so far. In the following section of this video, we will learn how to train your images, where to download different types of models and styles, how to create AI videos using Stable Diffusion, how to create images in the same pose, and how to upscale images. I just want to give you a break to experiment with what you have learned by ending this video here. Before ending this video, let me show you how to find the perfect prompt for your image generation. Let's open new tab and search for openart.ai. A quick disclaimer, you may find not safe for work 18 plus AI images on this site. So please visit this site when you are in a safe environment. Everything that you see here is not generated by Stable Diffusion. So some prompts may not work. To filter this, type a word that you are looking for and hit enter. And in the filter, disable all. And disable the rest of the things except the Stable Diffusion. Now you will get prompts to create something similar in Stable Diffusion. Select any image and you will find the details that helped create this image. Copy the prompt and paste it into your prompt box. Try playing with the prompt by replacing some words and generating something unique and beautiful using Stable Diffusion. Please give a like to this video. As soon as I reach 100 likes on this video, I will upload the next segment. If you are planning to post your result on social media, then use the hashtag BhagatGaurYouTube so everyone watching this video will see what you have created. Share this video with your friends, comment with your opinion on this video, and thank you so much for watching till the end. We will meet again in the next part. Bye.